Hey guys, meteorologist Chris Tomer here with this morning mountain weather update, and we got it here in Colorado. It is a powder day. Look at Loveland. This is one of the biggest 24-hour snowfalls we've had all season. 10 inches. I think that's probably a minimum, but 10 inches up there at Loveland Ski Area, still open for skiing. Arapahoe Basin, just over the pass, reporting 13 inches in the last 24 hours. You can see the guy snow blowing there, so this is a good storm on April 16th. It is a powder day. Looking at the numbers out of Alta, Utah, they're reporting about 8 inches in the last 24 hours. Let me show you radar. Here's what's left of the storm system. You can see the cyclonic curvature there with the rain up and down the I-25 corridor as expected, even a couple of rumbles of thunder. But all this is going to be winding down. The storm will be exiting Colorado today. That's part of what I'm seeing here in my bullet points this morning. So storm system departs today. Then there's a cold front that comes in very quickly on the heels of this through Montana, Wyoming, Colorado, 417 and 418. A third cold front, although trending weaker this morning, comes in 419 and 420, which will affect Colorado and might also affect Wyoming. And then we're into a warmer period, 423 and 427. I mean, this is definitely spring skiing, but you can get good days like this, where you get a storm system that rolls through with 10, 12, 13 inches of snow. Okay, let me take you back. I want to show you the forecast radar and satellite. Here's where we're headed. So by 5:30 this afternoon, a storm has exited Colorado and Wyoming, but look up to the north coming out of Banff and parts of BC dropping down into Montana. There's the next cold front. Hits Big Sky, parts of Jackson, Grand Targhee, the Tetons, the Wind Rivers, and then it drops down into Colorado during that time frame. So by Thursday in the morning, it's kind of brushing Colorado, and then it's going to be sliding on through. Here comes the final cold front right there. You see some snow up in Wyoming and also snow across the Continental Divide of Colorado, sitting low across Denver in the Front Range. That's on Saturday morning at 5, but not nearly as intense as what we had looked at yesterday afternoon. Not as the magnitude just isn't as big, and then it kind of slides on out. And by Sunday, we're back to pretty much dry conditions across Colorado. And then here comes the warmer period, 423 through 427, with some high-pressure ridging. Just overall, temps are going to be running above normal during that time period, with rain showers, as you can see right there, being the dominant form of precipitation. Okay, let me just look at the latest numbers. So rest of today through tomorrow, some leftover snow in Colorado, and then there comes that next cold front dropping out of BC into Montana and Wyoming. That's where you're going to get that accumulation on 417 into 418. Okay, next time period is 418 to 420, some leftover snow into parts of Wyoming, and also that front drops down into Colorado. We could see 2, 3, 4, 5 inches of accumulation on the Continental Divide, tilting down across the resorts and east. A little bit less as you go west of the Continental Divide. I really think that's going to be the case. A lot of this is going to sit east of the Continental Divide. Okay, final time period is pretty benign. 421 through 425, things really start to warm up and the snow production goes way down during this time period. All right, guys, that's going to do it for this morning mountain weather update. Get out there and enjoy it today, and I'll talk with you later.